Afternoon, everybody. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you so much for joining me. Please like, share, and subscribe. Back on the 23rd of this month, there was a magnitude 6.7 earthquake south of the Fiji Islands. It was upgraded, I think, to a 6.7. Now, 5 days later, there has been an earthquake swarm also south of that location in the Fiji Islands. 9 so far today, and the largest being a magnitude 6.6. As I reported on the 23rd, this is caused by the subduction of the Pacific plate going underneath and coming back up here along the Tonga Trench. And we also got the Indo-Australian plate slowly moving north. This area is known for lots of earthquakes and lots of volcanic eruptions. And the most latest earthquake was this magnitude 4.6 here. Let's see, did I put the data in there? No, I did not. I didn't download the data to see the seismic signature. But here you can see the latest being a 4.6. Yeah, it looks like it's trending going a little bit northwest. It's probably because of the subduction. For the last week, there's been 11 earthquakes. And in the last 24 hours, they got eight, so they must have dropped one. The 6.6 was 598.5 kilometers below sea level. So that would be about 371 miles in depth. Now, according to USGS, the Moment Tensor Ball, this is what's called a reverse earthquake, or a thrust earthquake, where one side rises up and the other side basically stays stationary, but it looks like we got movement going towards the southwest. Usually with thrust earthquakes, you would have a tsunami warning, but because it was so deep, yeah, there is no tsunami warning. So that's a good thing. Now here on Geoscope, it gives a little bit better picture of what's going on. Like I said, we got the Pacific plate subducting underneath the Indo-Australian location, and you see how it wanted to move. Going north, maybe a little bit north west. And then if I bring it down, you can see how it got stuck. So more than likely, there'll be another earthquake or more earthquakes, and probably even a larger one. Interesting that the 6.7, which was on the 23rd, is north of this location. So does that mean that they're going to have more earthquakes going south? Well, possibly. It's trying to move. Now, on the 24th, there was a magnitude 7.3 by Raoul Island. And there was a small tsunami when that one occurred. It was only about 7 inches high. And this earthquake was, how deep? Let's see. 49 kilometers in depth. So that was about 34 miles. Not as deep as what's occurring today. Maybe it'll just suddenly let loose and we'll have an earthquake along here, the New Hebrides Trench, or even Fiji. Hope not. So that's the latest I have about all this activity, the swarm that's going on there south of Fiji. Sending prayers to everybody. Yeah, be safe. If you have any thoughts or comments, please put them down below. Thank you very much for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe. And I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.